Hi, my name is Stephen Parrish, and today I will be talking a little bit about a blue ocean strategy and industry structure and how there are ways to improve profitability by using these mechanisms. The company I will be talking about is Fitbit. They are a health fitness tracker. And so one of the improvements to be able to increase Fitbit's industry level profitability would be to increase their spending on research and development. They are currently doing that, as we can see in 2015 and 2016, respectively. They spent $150 million and $320 million. So they doubled their R&D expenditures in a year. This compared to their gross profits of $901 million and $845 million in 2015 and 2016. That creates them spending 17% of their gross profit in 2015 on research and development, and 49% of their gross profit on research and development in 2016. One of the factors they need to worry about initially when they were a startup company is the threat of entry. And one of the reasons that is because they were a startup company, they were the leading manufacturer and producer of a fitness tracker. And so they really need to worry about other competitors coming in and entering the market that they've created. Some of their competitors are Garmin, which created a VivoSmart HA Plus, and then they also have Misfit Ray, which is another company that creates a more sleek light band, and those are some of their initial competitors. Once they were established a little bit, I believe that they need to worry about the power of the customer and the rival among existing competitors. One of the reasons is that customers will more than likely go to other places if you do not have the product that they are looking for, or you're not able to provide the function or benefit that they want, something that is actually useful for the customer themselves. And so in order to do this, Fitbit actually bought two smartwatch manufacturers, Pebble and Vector. And they did this in order to innovate and create what customers want. And this is to keep the customer around, since the customer does have the power to go somewhere else if they would like to purchase these products, such as Apple is another close competitor with the smartwatch that is a direct competitor. And so that's a rival among existing competitors is Apple. And so Fitbit released the smartwatch, the Blaze and the Surge, in 2016 and 2015. And those are to be able to innovate and create and add new characters to their market brand. And then also another way for them to increase profitability using a blue ocean pathway. So they would more than likely want to look across alternative industries. And the idea behind this is that their initial market was just the Fitbit fitness tracker, which was just tracking your health, your day in and out, calorie intake, steps, items like that, which you could utilize on your computer. And so that was kind of a one segment area. With Apple releasing the smartwatch and that news being out, Fitbit as well went along with that, and that is when they purchased Pebble and Vector, the other smartwatch manufacturers. And this was to get into alternative industries. So they were getting more into the smartwatch, which had different benefits and different functions. Also, something similar to Apple, they could get into potentially the healthcare factor. And so where Apple is looking into being able to manufacture smartwatches that is able to read your blood sugar level, so people that are diabetic don't have to actually poke themselves to get their blood to test for their blood sugars. It can be done directly through the skin via the watch. And so this would be crossing industries, going into the healthcare. And I believe that those benefits from increasing the R&D and using alternative industries can increase their profits.